What's good, everybody? For those of you guys who are new to my channel, my name is Sydney Baker Green. A lot of you guys know me as an international cinematographer and colorist, but today you guys are gonna get to learn about me as my job before I was a full-time photographer and filmmaker, and that is as a barista. It's no secret that with all the isolation due to COVID-19, that a lot of us are forced to stay home. And while a lot of our drive-up coffee shops are still open, the most responsible thing we can all do is brew coffee at home. And today, I'm going to teach you guys my favorite method to brew espresso at home. My lovely friends at Flair Espresso sent me the Flair Espresso Maker actually to do more of a travel series with it where I could really play around on my travels that I do across the world. Unfortunately, due to the social isolation and social distancing, all of my travel plans have really been canceled. So today, I'm going to teach you guys how you can use the Flair Espresso Maker to make coffee at home. The first thing you guys are going to want to do when you get the Flair Espresso Maker is assemble it. Once it's assembled, the first step to actually preparing your coffee is to heat the chamber. According to the manufacturer's instructions, all you have to do is get boiling water and put it in from the tea kettle into the chamber and let it sit for about a good 20 seconds to 30 seconds to allow the chamber to heat up. You can do this multiple times to increase the temperature within the chamber, therefore giving you better stability throughout your shot. However, here's my pro tip with that. I like to simply take the chamber and put it in a pot of boiling water. This is an extra step, but this will ensure that the chamber does reach 212 degrees and no hotter, but also no cooler. Water cannot get hotter than 212 degrees before evaporating, which means your boiling water is always sitting constantly at that mark. And because the chamber is made out of thermoconductive material, it will maintain its temperature stability throughout the shot when done this way. After that, you're gonna wanna get some coffee and, of course, a grinder. Flair Espresso has an awesome grinder on their website that you can use. I do not have access to that grinder, so we are going to use my EMC grinder that I have right here. It's recommended that you grind 16 grams to 18 grams of coffee. Now, how fine that coffee is depends on how fast your coffee is going to go through the extraction process. Each and every coffee is different. The coffee that I have here has a completely different grind setting compared to the coffee that I may get at Starbucks, for example. The Starbucks coffee is gonna run a lot slower, so I can't really give you that key, but this is where trial and error comes in, and that is the fun of dialing in coffee. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to remove the chamber from the hot water. You're gonna wanna use some type of tongs because it will be hot, and you're going to want to put the coffee in the portafilter. After you have your coffee in there, you can either use the plastic cap to tamp it, or you can use the tamper that comes with it. I like to use that tamper. Just be sure to remove the tamper slowly, as the puck can release from the portafilter if you move it too fast due to suction. After that, you're going to want to put the screen on top of the coffee bed and then put the top of the chamber on top of the portafilter. From there, you're going to take your boiling water from your tea kettle. I recommend always getting purified water, but if you only have access to tap water, that's fine. Just know that if you do have access to purified water, your coffee is going to taste much better. You're gonna wanna fill the chamber with the hot water, and once the hot water reaches the top, and don't be afraid if it overflows a little bit, you're going to wanna put the pressure gauge on top of the chamber. Now you are ready to start the extraction process. The ideal ratio that you're going to be looking for is going to be double the amount of coffee you put in there in about 30 seconds to 25 seconds, somewhere within that range. Each coffee tastes different at different times, so be sure to do what's more palatable for you. If you do have a scale, now would be the time to use your scale in addition to weighing your coffee that is dry and weighing your extraction time. I use the Akiya Lunar Scale, and I just simply place it underneath the Flair Espresso machine, put my cup on there, tear it out, and then start the timer while I'm doing the extraction. The nice part about this, although it is not an automatic machine, it's actually just an espresso maker, is that you have a lot more control than what you would get with an automatic machine, with the exception of temperature stability. So as you go through and you start your extraction, you're able, with using this pressure gauge, to pre-infuse at a certain pressure. I like to pre-infuse my coffee for about 4 to 5 seconds at about 4 to 5 bars. After that, you can ramp up your pressure with your hands to about 8 to 9 bars. Most espresso is pulled under 9 bars, so that is what I aim for. Although our strength stability is not perfect, we're gonna aim for that throughout the extraction. Again, if you put in 18 grams of coffee, then you're gonna wanna get 36 grams of coffee out, 19 grams of coffee, 38 grams out, and 20 grams of coffee, 40 grams out, etc., etc. After that, you can simply taste your espresso and see how you like it. There is no definite taste. Normally, it's up to the person's palate. Although us baristas do have a standard in which we like to pull our espresso, since you are making it at home and no one else is going to be consuming it, whatever tastes good to you is what will fly. I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, be sure to give me a big thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, turn on those post notifications if you have not. Be sure to follow me on my social media. The link is in the description down below, as well as the YouTube fam. Their links are also in the description down below. You can also find the link to the Flair Espresso Maker and the Flair Grinder down below. And be sure to let me know what you guys think in the comments. Remember, if you guys are ever feeling uninspired, uncreative, or just want to give up on life, every day, airplanes take off against the wind. Live, love, laugh, stay inspired, and as always, stay fabulous. My name is Sydney, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.